The hero in us is defined by what we do when nobody's looking. And if we look closely, they are everywhere. Ordinary people like you and me. Touching a life in their own little way. But what if there was a village, a city, or an entire nation that needed a hero? Heroes are only as big as the adversities they face, and the biggest of them all are known as the Pathbreakers. Just like life, greatness too is often constructed over a period of time as a 3X structure. 3X that constitute three distinct human emotions. The first emotion, the world may call simplicity. It is the hardest part. He called it rebellion. The second emotion the world may call madness. But the madness has a method to it. He called it renaissance. The final emotion the world may call peace. But peace often comes at a price. He called it redemption.
जल्दी आवा। He's trying from 10 years, but he always fails by little marks. He wants to have degree.
What keeps him going so long?
He has this little piece of inspiration. A story of a man. I don't know if you have heard of him.
I link the very heavens to the boundless earth. I am the ark to most of God's creation, blessed with beauty and strength alike. But lately, the respect I command has diminished. The realization of being more of a hindrance to His people has shattered my sheer pride of being the untiring force that I am. I was the mountain who remained unmoved for centuries. I had unknowingly plagued the villagers with innumerable problems. Even to earn a meager living, the villagers had to travel 75 long kilometers to reach the closest town of Vazirganj, or risk their lives to cross my majestic peak. Medical help and a school education seemed a world away. I had begun to question my ill-fated existence. The answer arrived in 1958, in the form of a woman who slipped on one of my rocks while carrying lunch to her husband on the other side.
आ देवा, स्कूल की छुट्टी वाल का।
बाबा, अम्मा।
No one knew at that time that the lives of the villagers of Ghelor Ghati would never be the same again. For I had dared to hurt the beloved of Dashrath Manji. This had become personal.
अब तू का कर बे? केते को खाना दे।
चुप मार के बैठ। हुल्ला जिन करा।
While the world was busy scaling new peaks of progress, this isolated village remained shackled and cut off from any progress. The villagers were utterly at my mercy.
इतना ही नहीं, वो तो बच्चों को लेके मायके जाता हुआ, हमें कुछ करेगा पड़ी।
जौन भगवान की मर्जी भैया, भाग से कौन लड़ सकत?
हम तो पहाड़ी के ऊ तरफ निकल जाब।
का? तो पुरखन की जमीन का होई?
अब जमीन तो बची बा, और ही का? जिधर नजर पड़े उधर जमी जमी, न दाना न पानी न दवा दारू न बच्चों के लिए स्कूल। उस मांझी के महरालू की हालत देख रहे
I remember the day he stood eye to eye with me. Something seemed different, and then.
But bahut ho gaya, bahut ho gaya, bahut ho gaya, bahut ho gaya.
Nobody expected him to do what he did after that. But I could see the beginning of my end. The tools of my destruction had arrived.
To ek waste apni bakri bhej diye. वही के दूध से तो अपना रोटी पानी चलत रहा।
ठीक है बैल ना, ओके दूध से हमार पेटवा गड़बड़ाई जात रहा।
This frail young man started to do what none before him had ever dared to even dream about. Dashrath Manji had resolved to destroy me, the mountain that hurt his wife, whom he loved no end. He wanted to tear me apart. It sounded simple, yet foolish. But somehow, this did not seem like an attempt. This felt like a mission. He came back every morning and chipped away through the day. It was hard to believe that he seemed stronger and more determined than the previous night.
पगला हो गया कि पहाड़ टूटेगा इसे, एक आदमी से पहाड़ टूटा है, इसके मारे से जनता लोग पगला गया, पगला गया।
दशरथ बाबा, इस उम्र में तेरे पागल काहे कहते हैं?
अरे देवा, ये लोग का समझिए कि हम का कर रहे थे।
देवा, अरे ओ देवा!
चिंता जिन कर, हम सब संभाल ले।
अरे ओ देवा!
बापू गुस्सा जिन करियो, हमें माफ कर दियो, अब हम यहाँ ना हो, बस पढ़ाई करो और कुछ ना।
दशरथ किधर गल?
He instantly knew there was something wrong. His spirit had been dealt a severe blow. Everyone thought he had no more reason to continue his mad mission. I waited for him for days on end, but in vain. The woman he had started this for was no longer there. But he did not give up. I could feel it. The power of his pounding increased. The drops of his sweat doubled, and the madness of his method never seemed clearer to me. Years passed by, but Dashrath didn't give up. They saw me get cut down to size, bit by bit. Yet, they wouldn't admit it.
पागल है ससुर के पागल है।
अब रणवा गए ना यही सब करिए।
I think this is the year I will do it.
You must be tired. Did today's paper go well?
Yes. I decided to write something different for the essay question this time.
Can you tell us about it?
Of course. I wrote a story about this man.
Hey, beta. Delhi ki darwa.
Wow.
Achha. Ta rail patri pakad lei.
Theek ba.
Hey, chacha. Ka kari ka jaat ho wahan?
Rashtrapati se milay pade.
This man walked all the way from his village to New Delhi, more than 1,000 kilometers. He wanted to meet the president personally regarding some facilities in his village. That wasn't all. He even managed to get signatures of the station masters at all the stations on the way. It took him over 2 months.
Very interesting. How did you come up with such a story?
I didn't come up with it.
The villagers began to see the method in his madness.
अब जल्दी खत्म होए के चाहिए। सब लोग दिल खोल के हंसी हैं।
I believed him when he said that. The pain that I had endured for years was starting to give me an unusual sense of satisfaction. I had started to feel secure in the hands of this man, my challenger, my conqueror, my companion.
Just see, it must be my results.
Dashrath Baba.
कोई वहां से गया बा
नमस्ते बाबा नमस्ते
कसम का अमरी कॉलेज जावा पढ़ाई पूरी करवा देवा
हाँ बाबा हाँ
पसीना तान के लग गया तब 22 बरस लगा तोड़े वाकई रास्ता को बना दिया।
पगलक कहते कहते इतना बड़ा नाम कर दे पहाड़ तोड़कर।
हमको भी अच्छा लगा आने जाने में।
Myself, देव कुमार यादव, बैचलर ऑफ आर्ट्स।
10th अटेम्प्ट हाँ?
But now I have fulfilled my promise. I can rest in peace.
Why did you take so long?
Oh, this was a tough course. Also, my schooling was difficult. It took a long time.
Why?
Well, when I was a child, these huge mountains separated our village from the towns that had schools.
Where was this?
Gehlor Ghati in Bihar. But then Baba came along. I remember he used to fondly call me Deva. Even now, I have this dream of Baba at complete peace with himself. Now that I have fulfilled his wish.
That incessant knocking sound that filled the village air for 22 long years had culminated in a dream. A path. A path straight through my heart and into the hearts of a whole nation for generations to come. I placed my fate in the hands of the mountain man and felt proud to do so. For he carved a path to his people's future.
Every year, I send you a greeting. But you know what? Today, Baba told me a very funny story, which Dr. Kaka told him. So, I also wanted to tell you that story. One day, Dr. Kaka was taking a walk after his dinner.
Kaya dao? Kaya shodun daile?
Dupari chabi arovli.
Chabi kute arovli hoti?
Tithe.
इथे कशाला शोधताय?
काय डॉक्टर साहेब, तिथे अंधार आहे, तिथे कधी सापडेल? इथे उजीड आहे, इथे सापडेल की?
डॉक्टर साहेब, तुम्ही अमेरिका सोडून इथे आला आणि जॉन्स हॉपकिन्स मधलं शिक्षण घेऊन आणि इथे दवाखाना सुरू केलात या ठिकाणी,
जेव्हा सगळ्या संशोधनाच्या सोयीसुविधा तिथे आहेत आणि तुम्ही इथे गडचिरोलीसारख्या समस्याग्रस्त जिल्ह्यात आलात का?
कारण भारतातील लोकांच्या आरोग्यांच्या समस्यांची हरवलेली चावी इथे गडचिरोलीच्या खेड्यांच्या अंधारात दडलेली होती. ती चावी जर इथे शोधू शकलो आणि इथले आरोग्याचे प्रश्न आपण सोडवू शकलो तर आम्हाला खात्री होती की आपण इथले आणि सगळीकडचेच आरोग्याचे प्रश्न सोडवू शकतो.
It was like Bapu telling me what he had earlier told my father. If you want to study economics, go to the villages of India. The seeds were sown. The path chosen was tough. But my growing up at Sevagram had taught me how to cope. Bapu's teachings were my very foundation. And I was only too glad to have found a wife in Rani who, despite her privileged upbringing, had similar beliefs as mine. But the journey was not to be an easy one.
And so, Dr. Kaka and Kaki started the hospital in our Gadchiroli. They also started research to find the key to some big lock. Baba says it will help all babies in the world. But Tai, they were only two. And there were so many villagers and so many babies.
या माळा लावण्याला एवढा औषध का केला?
डॉक्टर साहेब, मी शेतावर गेली होती. गेली नसती तर माझी एक दिवसाची रोजी बुडाली असती. दुपारी यायला निघाले तर
the death of the little girl could have been averted. I was right here and yet couldn't save her. What use was my medical education? The death of the little girl could have been averted. What use was my medical education? I was right here and yet couldn't save her. The death of the little girl could have been. I was right here. What use was my medical education?
The most helpless moment of my life.
Tai, that day, I don't know if Dr. Kaka was sad or angry. But he definitely looked determined to solve the problem he had come to know about. Small babies dying. Baba told me they call it child mortality.
I was fortunate to have studied in the school which was conducted on Mahatma Gandhi's thinking, Nayi Talim. His greatest gift, I suppose, was that more important than mere thoughts or speeches was action. We followed Bapu's approach and went to villages.
Dr. Kaka and Bangu Bai went with Baba to many people's houses in the villages here. They talked to all aunties who were to become mummies and who had small babies. They also talked to mummies whose babies had died, you know. And they did all this to find the problems. Why were so many new children dying?
We are getting 18 causes of infant mortality. These are not independent causes. These are 18 links in a chain. And the strength of a chain is equal to the weakest link in the chain. You break any one of those 18 links and the chain is broken. But that was easier said than done.
Nearly 92% of the women had gynecological problems.
40% of child deaths were caused by pneumonia. We doctors could treat it. But how could only two of us reach so many sick children? There was only one way out.
नमस्कार.
ही बाय कम्युनिटी हेल्थ वर्कर होऊ शकते का?
हीच काय, तुम्ही सगळ्या होऊ शकता.
पण डॉक्टर साहेब, एक्सरे सोडा, मला मोजणंही नीट येत नाही, तर मी कसं करू?
प्रत्येक प्रश्न आपलं उत्तर सोबत घेऊन येतो. याला उलट केलं तर ही वाळू पडणं सुरू होते. ही वाळू पूर्ण पडायला एक मिनिट लागेल. सोबत आपण बाळाचा श्वास मोजणं सुरू करायचं. दहा श्वास झाले की एक मणी सरकवायचा. असं एका मिनिटाच्या आत आपल्याला लाल मणी सरकवा लागला तर बाळाला काय म्हणून समजायचं?
निमोनिया झालं.
शाबास, आता तुम्ही डॉक्टर झालात.
दिस वे इलिटरेट बर्थ अटेंडंट्स इन विलेजेस वेर ट्रेन्ड टू डायग्नोस अँड ट्रीट न्यूमोनिया इन चिल्ड्रन सो दे कुड सेव्ह देअर ओन चिल्ड्रन. दिस वॉज आरोग्य स्वराज्य विच मेंट
पीपल्स हेल्थ
इन पीपल्स हँड्स. सच अ सिंपल आयडिया नो ताई, द ब्रेथ काउंटर. With this machine, they saved many, many lives. And you know what? To make each one, it only cost rupees 12.
Their indigenous method of checking through the breath counter proved to be 87% accurate when compared with modern scientific equipment. It was only too easy to accept it worldwide. Truly, limitations inspire innovation.
But Tai, the problems were still not over.
One wintry cold night, we heard cries of a woman. Next day morning, we found that a man was drunk in the night. He beat her up, burned his hut, and then deserted her and disappeared. There was a lone woman with children, with no support. This is what alcohol did to women and children.
When in doubt, what your next step should be, bring before your eyes the most miserable person you ever saw and ask yourself, will the next step I contemplate be of any use to him? Will it lessen his misery?
You know, Tai, Papa does not beat I at all anymore. He stopped drinking the day you left. Thanks to the efforts of Dr. Kaka and Bangu Bai.
In 1992, the Bungs' research and their achievements were published in The Lancet, the most esteemed medical journal worldwide. What we wanted to know is how they brought the infant mortality rate down from 121 deaths per 1,000 births, and what we saw amazed us. These community health workers in remote areas with few means at hand were no less than city gynecologists.
Tai, please tell Dev Bappa to send more people like Dr. Kaka and Kaki to us. And I told me you are coming back. Come soon now. We'll play lots and lots. And both of us will go and join Dr. Kaka's hospital to become doctors like him and Kaki.
I breathe in,
that pure morning breeze, the rich green trees, the sweet voice of the birds, a clear water stream, and maybe a cow grazing nearby. And suddenly, I wake up. It was all a bad dream. Or was it? Over the years, a small step for technology has often resulted in a giant stride for mankind. It is thus a common belief that the current generation is enjoying the best part of this technological revolution we often call the machine age. But are they really the benefactors? Is this really a revolution? As unreal as it may look, this could be my future. And this time, your fate is in your own hands.
So many letters?
Yes, we are not the only ones. Plastic manufacturers from all over the world are getting mails from people who want a world without plastic.
Plastic-free world?
Yes, they mean plastic-free world. I cannot imagine a world without plastic.
What is this?
Actually, it is interesting. A primary school teacher has mailed it to us. It is surprising that even children believe something is wrong.
तेरको मना किया था ना मना आने के लिए फिर से आई तो मना करने के बावजूद
क्या बात है नदीम
देखिए सर मना करने के बावजूद दोबारा प्लास्टिक चुनने के लिए बार बार आती है इधर
अरे छोड़ दो भाई वो दो चार पैसे कमाने आती है कमाने दो छोड़ दो छोड़ दो
थैंक यू अंकल
क्या है ये कातिल बोल रहा था
छोड़िए सर इसकी दो गाय थी वो कचरे में से प्लास्टिक खा के मर गई ये हमको बोलने से बेहतर है जो प्लास्टिक बनाते हैं उनको जाकर बोले
And so, a man named Ahmad Khan, who was one of the many culprits responsible for my slow but sure demise, decided to make a change. A change that would pave the path to a cleaner future, a greener future.
I was aware of this process being tested in other countries. It was not that new, but there was a difference. I do not know why anyone did not ever think of this earlier. It was simple. I was planning to kill two birds with one stone. So me and my brother Rasool Khan decided to create KK Plastic Waste Management Limited. Why waste all that plastic?
The city produces 30 tons of plastic waste every day. KKPWM collected plastic waste from all over Bangalore. From a meager 40 paise per kilo of waste plastic, KKPWM offered an amazing rupees 6 per kilo. Citizens from all strata of society contributed, from housewives to students and even rag pickers.
ये ले 48 रुपीस।
48 क्यों?
अरे हाउ मच इज 6 टाइम्स टू 8? तो स्कूल क्यों नहीं जाती? पैसे तो कमा रही हो।
ओके ओके।
सो द आइडिया इज वर्किंग वेल। आई कैन नॉट बिलीव दैट दे वर बीइंग पेड ओनली 40 पैसा पर किलो बिफोर दिस।
आई सेंस दैट विद होप and a little innovation, the healing process had well and truly begun.
Now for the hard part. Convincing workers in the city to let us carry out our experiment was a difficult task. At times they agreed, just to see what me and my brother were up to. Polymerized bitumen. We named it Polyblend. Actually, we used powdered plastic waste, not new plastic.
The cracks had started to disappear. Slowly but surely, I was starting to understand his ways. I saw a man on the brink of a long journey, a journey of faith and redemption.
The results were clearly visible. Our methods were working in more ways than one. But a lot of research was still needed. Someone had to monitor the durability of these roads. So I roped in Professor Justo, who is a renowned highway and road expert, and his colleague Professor Veer Raghavan. A student research team took up the project. This report was the result. It took us about 2 years. The use of waste plastic of 8% by weight of bitumen helps in substantially improving the stability and fatigue life of BC mix even under adverse waterlogging conditions. Therefore, the life of the pavement surfacing course using waste plastic is expected to increase substantially in comparison to the use of conventional bituminous mix. As you all can see, these are the related figures and statistics. And with that, I would like to conclude my presentation and thank our respected Chief Minister and Cabinet for your time. I hope you will all consider our proposal in earnest and work towards a cleaner society.
Reluctance made way for acceptance and pollution for infrastructure. A small part of me was starting to feel beautiful and pure again.
This was our signal to go ahead. One of the most important documents, the municipal corporation agreeing to our first official pilot project. ...40 kilometers of road in our city. Till date, they have not worn out. The word had started to spread. Everyone wanted to know about our work.
Hey, there's
समझा रहा इधर नहीं आना करके और कितने बार बोलना तेरे को इधर
कौन है ये क्या हो रहा है
ये कौन है मैं इसको जानता तक नहीं हूँ ये हमारा गार्बेज कलेक्टर ही है फिर भी रोज आता है इधर
But it was the little things that gave me immense satisfaction. मैं जानता हूँ आपको
मैं बस आपको थैंक यू बोलना चाहता था सर आपने पहला कदम उठाया बहुत मुश्किल हुआ होगा ना लेकिन आपने कर दिखा है सर मैं सब समझ गया सर प्लास्टिक प्रॉब्लम नहीं है हम जिस नजरिए से प्लास्टिक को देख रहे थे वो प्रॉब्लम है सर मैं आपकी मदद करना चाहता हूँ सर मुझे इसके लिए पैसे नहीं चाहिए सर पैसे नहीं चाहिए बस आप मेरा मदद ले लो सर प्लीज
ओके ओके This is the key to any idea. Execute it. Don't wait for someone else to do something. That man learned the hard way. But he learned to be proactive finally. He is one of the main suppliers of waste plastic to us today. So now anyone can tell me what is this?
It is a picture of our earth with lot of roads.
He's exactly right. Why waste? When it could be used as a raw material. Imagine, our country generates around 4,000 tons of waste plastic every day, out of which we can make 800 kilometers of road. So tell me, what did you learn today?
The plastic is not the problem, but the way we look at it is the problem.
And this is only the beginning.
I breathe in that pure morning breeze, the rich green trees, the sweet voice of the birds, a clear water stream, and maybe a cow grazing nearby. This could be more than just a dream. This could be my future.
A pathbreaker is the epitome of persistence. With a will to overcome all obstacles in one's path. Thus, setting off a one-man rebellion.
जौन भगवान की मर्जी भैया, भाग से कौन लड़ सकत।
हम तो पहाड़ी के ऊ तरफ निकल जाब।
का तो पुरखन की जमीन का हुई?
अब जमी तो बची बा, और ही का, जिधर नजर पड़े उधर जमी जमी, ना दाना ना पानी ना दवा दारू ना बच्चों के लिए स्कूल।
हाँ हाँ, वहाँ बढ़िया नौकरी मिलत रहे, जो मन करे तो घर आ जाए, और कोनो तरीका ना।
I was the mountain who remained unmoved for centuries. I had unknowingly plagued the villagers with innumerable problems. Even to earn a meager living, the villagers had to travel 75 long kilometers to reach the closest town of Vazirganj, or risk their lives to cross my majestic peak. The answer arrived in 1958. In the form of a woman who slipped on one of my rocks while carrying lunch to her husband on the other side. No one knew at that time that the lives of the villagers of Ghelor Ghati would never be the same again. For I had dared to hurt the beloved of Dashrath Manji. This had become personal.
अब तू का कर बे? केते को खाना दे।
चुप मार के बैठ, हुल्ला जिन करा।
I remember the day he stood eye to eye with me. Something seemed different, and then.
बस, बहुत हो गया, बहुत हो गया, बहुत हो गया, बहुत हो गया।
Nobody expected him to do what he did after that. This frail young man started to do what none before him had ever dared to even dream about. He wanted to tear me apart. It sounded simple, yet foolish. He came back every morning and chipped away through the day. But alas, his spirit had been dealt a severe blow. The woman he had started this for was no longer there. But he did not give up. The villagers began to see the method in his madness. I had started to feel secure in the hands of this man. My challenger, my conqueror, my companion.
Namaste Baba,
that incessant knocking sound that filled the village air for 22 long years had culminated in a dream. A path. A path straight through my heart and into the hearts of a whole nation for generations to come. I placed my fate in the hands of the mountain man and felt proud to do so. For he carved a path to his people's future. A pathbreaker is driven in his work by a superseding sense of altruism. Hence, bringing about a new beginning, a renaissance.
डॉक्टर साहेब, तुम्ही अमेरिका सोडून इथे आला आणि जॉन्स हॉपकिन्समधलं शिक्षण घेऊन आणि इथे दवाखाना सुरू केला या ठिकाणी.
जेव्हा सगळ्या संशोधनाच्या सोयीसुविधा तिथे आहेत आणि तुम्ही इथे गडचिरोलीसारख्या समस्याग्रस्त जिल्ह्यात आलात, का?
कारण भारतातील लोकांच्या आरोग्याच्या समस्यांची हरवलेली चावी इथे गडचिरोलीच्या खेड्यांच्या अंधारात दडलेली होती. ती चाबी जर इथे शोधू शकलो आणि इथले आरोग्याचे प्रश्न आपण सोडवू शकलो तर आम्हाला खात्री होते की आपण इथले आणि सगळीकडचेच आरोग्याचे प्रश्न सोडवू शकतो. द सीड्स वेअर सोन, द पाथ चोझन वॉज टफ, बट माय ग्रोईंग अप ॲट सेवाग्राम हॅड टॉट मी हाऊ टू कोप. Bapu's teachings were my very foundation. And I was only too glad to have found a wife in Rani who, despite her privileged upbringing, had similar beliefs as mine. But the journey was not to be an easy one.
बाळाला आणायला एवढा औषध का केला?
डॉक्टर साहेब, मी शेतावर गेली होती. गेली नसती तर माझी एक दिवसाची रोजी बुडाली असती. दुपारी यायला निघाले तर
The death of the little girl could have been avoided. I was right here and yet couldn't save her. What use was my medical education? The most helpless moment of my life.
Tai, that day, I don't know if Dr. Kaka was sad or angry. But he definitely looked determined to solve the problem he had come to know about. Small, small babies dying. Baba told me they call it child mortality. And so, Dr. Kaka and Kaki started the hospital in our Gadchiroli. They talked to all aunties who were to become mummies and who had small, small babies. They also talked to mummies whose babies had died, you know. And they did all this to find the problems. Why were so many new children dying?
But that was easier said than done.
Nearly 92% of the women had gynecological problems.
40% of child deaths were caused by pneumonia. We doctors could treat it. But how could only two of us reach so many sick children? There was only one way out.
याला उलटं केलं तर ही वाळू पडणं सुरू होते. ही वाळू पूर्ण पडायला एक मिनिट लागेल. सोबत आपण बाळाचा श्वास मोजणं सुरू करायचं. 10 श्वास झाले की एक मणी सरकवायचा. असं एका मिनिटाच्या आत आपल्याला लाल मणी सरकवा लागला तर बाळाला काय म्हणून समजायचं? शाबास, आता तुम्ही डॉक्टर झालात.
दिस वे इलिटरेट बर्थ अटेंडंट्स इन विलेजेस वेर ट्रेन्ड टू डायग्नोस अँड ट्रीट न्यूमोनिया इन चिल्ड्रन सो दे कुड सेव्ह देअर ओन चिल्ड्रन. दिस वॉज आरोग्य स्वराज, which meant
people's health
in people's hands. Such a simple idea, no Tai? The breath counter. With this machine, they saved many, many lives. And you know what? To make each one, it only cost rupees 12.
In 1992, the Bungs' research and their achievements were published in The Lancet, the most esteemed medical journal worldwide. What we wanted to know is how they brought the infant mortality rate down from 121 deaths per 1,000 births, and what we saw amazed us. These community health workers in remote areas with few means at hand were no less than city gynecologists.
A pathbreaker is a pioneer who works ceaselessly for his community, for no personal gain, thus single-handedly achieving for us our redemption, the road to recovery.
As unreal as it may look, this could be my future, a future shrouded in plastic. And this time, your fate is in your own hands. And so, one such manufacturer of plastic from Bangalore took up the cudgels to relieve me from my agony. Ahmad Khan, who was one of the many culprits responsible for my slow but sure demise, decided to make a change. A change that would pave the path to a cleaner future, a greener future.
It was simple. I was planning to kill two birds with one stone. So me and my brother Rasool Khan decided to create KK Plastic Waste Management Limited. Why waste all that plastic? We were planning to use this plastic waste to build much needed infrastructure for the city.
The city produces 30 tons of plastic waste every day. KKPWM collected plastic waste from all over Bangalore. From a meager 40 paise per kilo of waste plastic, KKPWM offered an amazing rupees 6 per kilo. Citizens from all strata of society contributed, from housewives to students, and even rag pickers. I sense that, with hope and a little innovation, the healing process had well and truly begun.
Polymerized bitumen. We named it Polyblend. Actually, we used powdered plastic waste, not new plastic. Plastic waste collected from all over Bangalore is mixed with bitumen to form Polyblend. This blend is used to lay new roads. Plastic significantly alters the properties of bitumen and thus doubles road life as compared to conventional bituminous roads.
Reluctance made way for acceptance and pollution for infrastructure. A small part of me was starting to feel beautiful and pure again.
This was our signal to go ahead. One of the most important documents, the municipal corporation agreeing to our first official pilot project. 40 kilometers of road in our city. Till date, they have not worn out.